All right, dropping off my car here at Table Rock. Got Uncle Matt helping me out as shuttle master again. And excited. This is going to be my third attempt for a thru hike of the Foothills Trail.
I'm excited for him, too.
So brought a couple of luxuries with me on this trip to make it a little bit more festive. 76.2 miles. Uncle Matt, he's going to walk with me a little ways here on the trail. I'm going to head down, and it's going to be fun. I'm going to be doing this trip solo this time, except for this first part with Uncle Matt. It is December the 15th, 2012, and I'm looking forward to completing the trail in its entirety this time. It may be raining some tomorrow and the next day, but we will see and go from there. I've been hiking for about 40 minutes. Got some reasonable views out through the trees. I'm been going uphill for a little bit, so I'm starting to feel a little windy. Left Uncle Matt about 30 to 40 minutes ago. Yeah, 30 minutes ago. We hiked together for about 10 minutes. That was nice. Enjoying myself. It was real cool when I started. I think it's probably about the same. I'm just really heating up. It is a nice day. I think it was 38 when I started. You can kind of see up here on the hill the fire tower and such. There's the buildings, tower up top. Fire tower's up there somewhere, but it is not accessible by, it's all barbed wire fenced off. Anyways, Florida Rider, shout out to you, sir. You and the missus are doing well. Just came down some stairs. Oh, stairs are always so much fun. Looks like the day's starting to lighten up some. I like it. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I've got glorious feeling. Everything's going my way. Oh, more stairs. There's water all over the place here. I really do like the Foothills Trail. Little waterfall down there. Traveled 4.6 miles in an hour and 30 minutes. That was a little slower than I wanted, but you know, hey, whatever. This is fun. So, I'm loving it with the sun coming out like this. Keep seeing these white blazes, and it's welcome. Glad to have you on the trail. All right, crossing over South Carolina Highway 107. It's 11:08. I've done 6.1 miles in about 2 hours, so that's roughly 3 miles an hour. I've got 10.4 miles to Burroughs Ford and 70.2 miles until I get to Table Rock. There are quite a bit of yellow jackets out, sorry with the sun. just gonna hike on by them. Starting to get a little tired, so I know that my energy levels are running a little low. You know, you get excited before a trip like this, and kind of wears you down on the sleep the day before. So I've got some peanut butter and jelly sandwiches to look forward to. I'll probably eat those around 12:30. That'll really give me an energy boost. Stairs. I'm starting to sweat again. And I'm real tired. I don't know. Lots of stairs. Feeling all right. Sweaty. Trying to keep the sun out of your eyes. So once upon a time, I used to own one of these Gerber paraframe knives. Same size and everything. I just found one on the same trail I lost it. Like, I don't know. Back in 2006. No, did I lose it there? No, I lost it on the Art Lobe. Never mind. Well, this is one of my favorite water stops before continuing on up the climb that's ahead of us. About to meet up with the Bartram Trail. Past the first campsite, heading towards Table Rock. It really looks like a campsite. There's places that look like you could camp. That's an established site. No blisters. Feeling great as far as my feet. A little tired. And running a little slow. But I think that a change of pace might do me good for a little while. I'm really thinking about how much I love my wife right now. Honey, you are beautiful, smart, and I am looking forward to seeing you. Three wild turkey. Just scared me. They were hiding in the in the rhododendron and stuff down here towards my left. I believe you can see all that. And there's kind of a cliff. Trail goes along it. Mom, I'm not dangling precariously off of it or anything. No unnecessary risks, remember. For me to remain on my target, my goal, the trip plan that I left with my family, I need to make it up and over this hill in an hour. That should be doable. 45 minutes would be a lot better. I don't know. I'm enjoying it. It's a beautiful day out here. Scenery's great. It's definitely not too hot. My fingers still feel chilled, but the rest of my body is nice and toasty. I'm thankful I do not have blisters yet, and I'm hoping that continued good foot care and maintenance will prevent that.
I'm not sure how much of this you can see, but boy, oh Lord, this is an incredible sight. Let me try to zoom in down there through the trees if I can. Maybe not. Look at that. The water's just roaring. Beautiful.
All right, well, stopped and talked with some fellow backpackers here on the Foothills Trail. Came down to the same spot that Florida Rider and I did some swimming back in the summertime. Some guys who have been considering hammocks, but said a little too expensive. So tried to talk to them about the DIY versions, and also maybe lighten their load a little bit. Guys, what do you think about last night?
It was pretty cold, but it was nice. We appreciate the information that you give us. And yeah. I'm Stuart Kaysen. I'm from Emmons, South Carolina.
And I'm Brett Flom. I'm from Emmons also, right. South Carolina. We had a long trip, and we learned a couple of things. Our first backpacking trip, actually, and you know, we've done other trips with the family, but we want to do it just the guys. And we learned, first of all, the weight of the pack. Mine's like 40-some pounds, and it was way too heavy. I think a 20-pound pack would be good for me, and I got a lot of, like, redoing stuff. Yeah. Well, I was beat last night.
Oh, yeah. Well, gentlemen, Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas. You do the same.
That's kind of cool. Look at that, like, cave in the water. That is just so pretty. I just came from over there. Look at this.
awesome. Just gorgeous. I mean, incredible view here. It is 2:07 and I'm sad. I realize at this point I've still got 4-ish miles, 4 to 4.5 miles to get to Burles Ford. I still have to go up and I'm still planning on going up and seeing the Kings Creek Falls for George, so I can get some photos and stuff. I told my family I was going to be 2:30 getting to Burles Ford. That's 22 minutes away from now. There's no way I can do 4.5 miles or so in 22 minutes. Not even without a pack and just running on flat road. Not that fast. Where do I really want to be? Take a look back at the river again, and I'm gonna pick up my pace again. Here we go. Another flight of stairs. It is 2:42. I'm getting closer and closer to Burles Ford. I was here last week trout fishing for the first time with my dad. First time fishing with him in about, I don't know, maybe 12 years or so? Something like that, 12, 16 years. And I know I'm getting closer because of where we're at.
All right, King Creek Falls. That's cool. You see all of it? Man, that's nifty.
All right, just met a real nice couple from Chicago. They didn't hike here. They're real nice. On my way to, once I get back down to where the trail splits to come up here, I'm going to go ahead and fill up not only this water bottle, but also my my soft-sided Nalgene. I don't know if I'm going to make it all the way to Sloan Bridge tonight, and I want to make sure I've got the water if I have to stealth somewhere in between. I'll tell you, I'm probably burning more calories than I'm taking in today. Tomorrow I packed quite a bit more. I'm not normally very hungry on the first day out. But I'm looking forward to that steak.
Real nice couple. That's the ones from up north.
This is the river. It comes down from King Creek Falls. Down this way is where Kyle and I camped last time. Sumter National Forest. The full spin around. Headed to Burles Ford. 3:43. I am like an hour and 15 minutes late. I got started on the trail late. And I took about an hour late, and then I took about a 30-minute lunch break instead of a 15-minute lunch break. So I'm kind of kicking myself a little bit, but I feel wonderful after visiting the parking lot and the amenities. So now I'm going to try to attempt getting as close to Sloan Bridge as possible. No idea where that's going to put me.
All right.
It is 5:13. It's definitely getting chilly. Sun's going down. Shout out to Lymphocytosis on Hammock Forms for this awesome buff. Got some DIY wristies on. And I got my little skin down I dropped on. I ain't sweating this one and be all right. I've got roughly 3 miles left to go until I really want to make camp tonight. So I got my headlamp out. I'm ready to go. So long as I keep moving, I'm warm. As soon as I get into camp, I've really got to get my warm stuff on and then get my fire going. So you'll see up here, that's South Carolina Highway 107. Very close. This is good. Ready to go and set up camp. I'm tired.
But it's been a really good day. God has blessed me. Right at 56 miles left to go. I've started feeling some amazing prayers coming my way from my mom, dad, wife, I guess whoever else was praying for me. Right around the time I normally just start feeling like I want to go home. See, the thing is, I really like hiking. I don't really like camping. Hammock camping makes it a lot easier for me to camp. But I'm still just, you know, if I had the option to stay at home and sleep beside my wife, I'd really like that. But you know, just because I don't, or because I have to continue hiking tomorrow, I need to camp out. That's a means to an end. So anyways, oh man, I'm really starting to look forward to that steak. It's probably going to be too dark for a lot of filming later without the fire and the headlamp going, so I'll try to get some footage before I go to bed, plus a Christmas surprise. Well, I'm night hiking. Definitely getting chilly. Just stopped, got a little bit of water. It is right at 6:15. I'm hoping to be in camp in the next maybe 15 minutes or so. That would put me right at about an hour behind schedule, which makes sense. That'd be really good for the night hiking I've been doing. I just turned my headlamp on. As you can see, I'm sure it's dark. It's very difficult to see. once I started tripping, that's when I turned on my headlamp.
Well, we got Christmas lights here on the hammock ridgeline. Back up and kind of see. Let's see if you can see in here. Look at that. Got the tarp pitched low. I think it's supposed to rain tonight. I'm out here cooking my food. Let's see if we got a boil. Okay. Using the caldera cone with the Inferno. And let's see what we're looking like in here right now. Oh, we got a boil. That's great. Well, Medicine Man, this is a shout out to you. After doing some night hiking, I'm using my new caldera cone system with the Inferno. Got some charcoal going on down in there. And I've got some T-bone steak that I pre-cut and marinated. Oh my God, this is gonna be incredible. Thanks for the idea. I'm going to be enjoying this thoroughly. Phew! Warm.